There has been a frenzy of Sims 4 news lately, as if the 21st anniversary wasn't enough of a surprise. We got slam dunked with the news that bunk beds are coming in March, and now this leak about Sims 4 kits, a brand new type of content, which was confirmed to be true by the Sims team themselves. I know it's a lot to take in, and I haven't had the chance to absorb it all. Before I start, I need to give you fair warning. I'm going to be critical in this video. Some of you will disagree with me, and that's okay. Everyone's opinion is valid. If it's constructive and we respect one another. For those of you who don't know what kits are, I'll give you a brief overview. Low Poly Pancake was the first, I believe, to find the source of this leak. They had looked at the tuning notes of the latest patch and digged around the game files and unearthed some screenshots and official descriptions about these kits. I'm heading over to the Sims VIP to get all the descriptions for you. Kits are many bits of content designed to enhance the way you play. Each kit is a little bit different. Play around, explore our kits. And the first one is called The Sims 4 Bust the Dust Kit. And that basically just gives us a vacuum where we can dust off things and tidy up. The second one is called The Sims 4 Country Kitchen Kit. And it's given us a few kitchen items from vintage refrigerators to casserole dishes and a few build and buy objects. And the third one, we have the Sims 4 Throwback Fit Kit, which has some really cute athletic wear for your Sims that are retro inspired. Surprisingly, out of nowhere, the Sims team decided to confirm that the leak was true by posting this tweet. Well, we're hoping to surprise you with the new content, but since you beat us to it, the Sims 4 kits are coming. Stay tuned for more details on March 2nd. There's several reasons why I'm not overjoyed and I'm a bit worried about these kits. It's not that I don't like the content. I mean, sure, I want my Sims to vacuum. I want my Sims to have these cute kitchen items. That we have already three types of DLC and we're now 7 years into the game. What is the purpose of giving us a new type of content so late in the game? I have a theory that I'll go over later, so keep watching. The description, mini bits of content, does scream out microtransactions to me. I mean, they haven't even called it a pack, it's now a kit. The funny thing is, we have stuff packs. Those were designed to have smaller bits of content in the game, so why have they become even smaller? These kits are unlikely to be free either. There's going to be a price structure attached to them. Some Simmons have said it's very reminiscent of the Sims 3 store. I've not played The Sims 3, so I can't comment on that, but do let me know if you think that these kits are going to be similar to The Sims 3 store. It seems like these kits that we have now could have easily been put in other packs. The vacuum, for instance, would have suited laundry day. I know laundry was just about cleaning clothes, but it has a general theme of cleaning. The fit kit had potential to be in the fitness stuff pack, and the country kitchen had the potential to be in other packs too. I have a feeling I know why they decided to call it a kit and not a pack, because we've had all these packs before. In my opinion, the Sims team are reusing the same themes and adding a price tag on them because they've just repackaged it. I know some of you are going to say to me, "Oh, Star, if you don't like it, just don't buy it." But the thing is, I like the content. I'm just disappointed that I have to pay extra for something that could have been included elsewhere. I'm also really wary because I feel like the more they introduce different layers of DLC, the more the game gets diluted. Expansion packs will have less content in them or won't have as much depth as before, and features that should have been combined or put in an expansion will be split up into smaller packs or kits. I'm afraid it's going to have a knock-on effect on the game as a whole. Some people have already criticised the game for having shallow gameplay, kits are not going to be giving us the depth we're looking for. I mean, kits are just small additions to the game that will act as fillers or distractions, whichever way you look at it. Remember when I questioned why they decided to bring kits out now, 7 years down the line? Well, I have a theory. Hold on to your hats, because this might be a crazy one. We recently had some hints from job listings that EA are potentially working on The Sims 5. It may be no coincidence that the introduction of kits have come at the same time that they're hiring people to work on The Sims 5. What if the kits serve as a pilot trial for The Sims 5? If these kits sell well, they could introduce more types of microtransactions to The Sims 5 that might pave the way to loot boxes. We all know that EA have a history of using microtransactions and loot boxes in their games. They've been heavily criticised for it, but it hasn't stopped them. These kits might be the start and used to subtly transition us to loot boxes in The Sims 5. I don't like loot boxes, I don't like the idea of paying for something and not knowing what you're getting, and you guys might think that's a stretch, but just think about it for a moment. EA are renowned for using loot boxes and microtransactions. It's like a trademark strategy. If they were to introduce loot boxes for The Sims 5, they would do it very subtly. It might be a gradual process. They might start with just using microtransactions, and they will most definitely repackage it to make it look like it's not a loot box, just like they've done with the kits. Remember, they're not packaged as packs. Kits are also smaller and must be less labour intensive than creating expansions and other packs. The game is in its 7th year, and these kits may be a quick and easy way to recoup any losses before production ends on The Sims 4. Bad Laurie had tweeted a reply to one of my tweets that they're afraid that the kits are a sign that they're winding down production on The Sims 4, and that towards the end they'll only be giving us kits and fizzling out packs. I do believe that The Sims 4 is still incomplete and there's still tons of content missing. I do hope that there's still a couple of years left of The Sims 4, and I'm sure if they are working on The Sims 5, then it's still in its early stages. I know I've been incredibly critical in this video and focused mainly on the negatives. I know not all of you will like that. Some of you will have different opinions and some of you will agree with me. I want to hear your opinion. I want to know what you think. So let's continue the chat in the comments. Keep shining, and I'll see you soon, guys. Bye.